don't be afraid to sit at the big tables. If even if it's not you contributing, sitting there and listening at the big tables, you get advice and you get info, which is important.
99FM, your inspiration station. It's that time to give you your Royal Hustlers. And you know, as always, Royal Hustlers, we want to give you something different. Today, technically, we have my colleague in the building. This morning, we had Tiaan Botha, a skilled professional with a bachelor's in financial accounting, postgraduate in diploma in business management, and background in auditing. He joined Future Media in 2001 as a finance manager of debtors. His expertise allows him to excel in his role, contributing to the country's financial success. He is in studio with us today to chat it up a little bit about his life and his career. Tiaan, good morning.
Morning.
How are you this morning?
I'm good, thanks.
Are you a morning individual?
I am actually not a morning individual.
Yeah. You don't like the morning.
I'm a night owl. I'll give you that.
Got you.
But yeah, I have become a morning individual.
You have become a morning individual by force. They're forcing you to become a morning individual.
No, it's not a force. It's I think it's a natural.
Got you.
Natural habit of life, the older you work.
The older you are.
And I became a dad about 15 months ago.
Hey, so congratulations.
Thanks. Eh?
So you are up at night and you are up in the morning.
Yeah, well, I try to go to bed earlier now.
Actually.
You work around their lives now.
Your schedule is around their schedule. Yes. When they wake up, you wake up. Here's one thing that I've learned, because I have two boys. And the advice I could give you is, when the baby sleeps, you sleep. Make sure when the baby sleeps, you sleep.
Yeah,
because if you don't sleep and they wake up and you're so tired, now you want to go to bed, they won't keep you up. But nonetheless, let's jump into this. Tell us a little bit about your childhood and how that contributed to the person you are this day.
So, I grew up not far from here. Mm-hmm. We grew up in Okanya.
Yeah.
Went to primary school there. Loved it. It was a small town, safe town. You got on your bike, went to your friends, came back just before dusk, and you're like, okay. So it was nice growing up there. It's a nice quiet town.
Yeah.
But always had a thing for numbers and figures.
Got you.
Got blessed with that talent. I understand it quite easily. I grasp it, and I think from a young age, that has sort of been my direction in life.
Got you. So you just decided to pursue this numbers thing.
Yeah, it's as I said, it comes quite naturally to me. Mm-hmm. So it was quite an obvious choice.
Got you.
As any teenager, I had some phases where no, I want to be this or I want to be that. Mm-hmm. But in the end of the day, it came back down to numbers.
What are some of the things that keep you grounded and motivated in life?
I think the what keeps me grounded is there's always more to learn. Some famous person once said, if you're the smartest person in the room, you're in the wrong room.
You're in the wrong room.
So, and what keeps me motivated is my family. I love my wife and I love my child, and I would love to provide for them for as long and possible as I can.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
How do you maintain a positive work-life balance outside of work and business? What do you get up to?
So outside of work, I love my sports.
What kind of sports are we talking
about? Well, basically anything, but if I had to choose, I love squash. I love, I've played some ultimate frisbee. I don't know if you know that game.
No, I know frisbee. I haven't played. I know that you throw a thingy, it goes into the air, you catch it on the other side.
Yeah, it's quite a fun sport. You need to be super fit for it, but it's also a nice casual social sport.
Nice.
So I love my sports. I love doing stuff with my hands. I love building stuff, wood, anything, steel, whatever.
What is one thing that you've built that you're so proud of?
So when me and my wife just started going out, she just moved to Ventuk, had no furniture in her flats or whatsoever, and I just decided, no, I'm going to build her some some bedside tables.
What?
So those are still standing in our house.
Till this day.
4 years later.
It means you did a good job.
Yeah.
But yeah, I know you're a busy man.
That's something I'm proud of.
Yeah, I know you're a very busy man, and I do want to let you go. Is there any leadership and business advice you would like to share to our listeners this morning?
Well, my advice is don't be afraid to sit at the big tables. Yeah. Even if it's not you contributing, sitting there and listening at the big tables, you get advice and you get info, which is important. And on that, you can make decisions in your own life and even get advice from people with much more life experience than you, just to help you go forward.
Tiaan, my brother, thank you so much for taking time out of your busy day to speak to us.
That's a pleasure.
Enjoy the rest of your day, man.
Thank you.
And there you have it. Do not be afraid to sit at the big table, because it is at the big table that you get to learn.
That was 99FM's Royal Hustle.